as a Farhana binti Razli, BMF 2001-005.
So today I will present about historical growth of Islamic banking in Indonesia. So Islamic banking in Indonesia formally began in 1990 using Banking Act No. 7/1992 about banking, which accommodated banks' activities with profit sharing principle. Oh, during 1992 until 1998, it's about 6 years of operation. There is practically no other regulator that support the system of Islamic bank operations. So there is absence of these legal tools to confirm such as conventional product. So end up, there is no difference between Islamic banking and conventional bank, even though the Islamic banking is using Sharia law. So the government take a further step, which is a strategic step to develop the Islamic bank. So after the government take a further step, they expected to provide a more solid legal basis and greater opportunities in the development of Islamic banking in Indonesia, so that equal and parallel into the conventional bank. So we can see in 2001, Islamic bank finance is more a greater or more grower than conventional bank, which is Islamic bank is 60%, about 60% grower. Meanwhile, the conventional bank is about less than 20%. So we can see that people or societies are using Islamic banks more than conventional bank. And the highest is in the year of 2004, which is Islamic bank has reached about less or more than 100% or less than 120%. Meanwhile, for the conventional bank, it's just less than 20%. But why suddenly after 2004, suddenly they go downward just like that? So Adina will explain what happened or what problem that Indonesia faced during that year. Thank you.
Okay, assalamualaikum, I am Zeti. So I'm going to present to you about fund size in Islamic banking of Indonesia. Okay. Next, in comparison to banking, the Bank of Indonesia predicts that the Islamic banking industry will develop rapidly. And the forecast is based on the more favorable macroeconomic and microeconomic factors that influence the speed and growth of the economy. So this is the total asset of Indonesia Sharia banking sector. Next is the value of Islamic banking assets is steadily increasing because of the dual banking system. Islamic banking assets are increasing. For example, the Islamic capital market, the Islamic obligation suku, or the Islamic stock can be the monetary instrument which are dealt in the exchange. The majority of this money are still held in the traditional banks, and their total value is estimated to be 26 rupiah trillion. Okay, next. The second type of funds is one which is handled by state-owned enterprise. So, it's worth noting that the Islamic banking industry overall asset were 100 rupiah trillion in December 2010, and that if all Hajj monies and merely 10% of the BUMN assets were placed in Islamic bank, so the total asset will be 3 times bigger than they are now. Okay, and then this is the some percentage IBF of Indonesia. Firstly, is driving halal food and modest fashion business. Had 8, the country rise in the rankings. Next, according to Indonesia's largest Islamic banking, Sharia banking is poised for a period of rapid growth as demand for financial product based on Islamic principles. So this year the lending anticipate its lending to grow by 11 to 12%. Okay, lastly, provide alternative to traditional financial instrument rather than charging interest because it is forbidden by Al-Quran, and profit sharing, leasing, and capital market instruments such as zero coupon bonds offer at a discount are example of this. So Islamic banking, according to Bank Indonesia, are less likely to engage in speculative activity, which will improve the financial sector stability. Okay, next, Safwan will continue.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Muhammad Safwan Akil bin Ahmad Zaini from Kelas DBF 6A, BMF 2001-002. I want to explain about growth rate of fund. The first one is table of content. The first one is our team. Second one is introduction. The third one is glory, and the last one is conclusion. The first one is our team. My name is Muhammad Safar Akhil bin Ahmad Zaini from class DBF 6A, PMF 2001002. Next is growth rate of Islamic and conventional banking fund from the year of inception until the present date. When the growth of Islamic and conventional bank is compared, it is clear that the Islamic banking industry has outperformed the regular banking industry in terms of socialization, instrumental innovation, and bank product. Islamic banking serves as both a financial and commercial institution as well as a social finance institution because its participation in social activities generates favorable feeling in all areas. It is quite advantageous as a first step in developing an Islamic banking strategy and full package. According to the Bank of Indonesia, the Islamic banking industry will grow at a faster rate than conventional banking in general. This forecast is based on more favorable macroeconomic and microeconomic debt factor that influence the speed with which the Islamic banking business develop. It is also backed by a plan to develop new Islamic business unit or Islamic commercial banking, as well as the optimization of Islamic banking business capacity and support for the national Islamic financial environment. A number of factors have contributed to the rapid expansion. There are the growing number of branches, office, Islamic banking activity, and profit sharing program, all of which are more stable in the face of macroeconomic downturn. When traditional bank interest rate fall, the profit sharing margin rise because the profit sharing arrangement is based on agreed upon benefit rate, this occur nisbah. The rapid growth of Islamic bank also occurs in Indonesia. The data of Indonesia bank from 2012 until 2017 showed that Islamic bank in Indonesia have asset development as many 28.42% annually, while conventional bank have asset development as many 11.91%. This means that the achieved growth of Islamic bank was higher than the growth of conventional bank. The rapid expansion of Islamic bank asset provided opportunities to for bad debt to expand non-performing financing. Despite various strategic concerns and challenges, Indonesia Islamic banking industry has continued to grow. According to the Islamic banking transformation study conducted in 2018, several strategic issues such as a lack of business model differentiation, suboptimal human resource in terms of quality and quantity, and low level of literacy and inclusion are impeding faster growth of the Islamic banking business. Furthermore, because the COVID-19 pandemic and need for social separation, global conditions have forced us into new normal age, which has impacted social and economic behavior. On the other hand, concern for one another well-being has grown, particularly in relation to financial matters. This can be viewed as both a problem and opportunity for the Islamic banking industry to provide digital-based services, contribute to post-pandemic economic development by meeting social requirements. Lastly is conclusion. The increasing focus for Indonesia Islamic banking sector is based on a better economic environment, continued regulatory forbearance, and a sustained policy push from the government. That's all from me, Muhammad Safar Akhil bin Ahmad Zaini from Class DBF 6A BMF 2001002. Thank you.
Hi, Assalamualaikum. My name is Adina binti Kazri and my ID number is BMF 2001013. Today, I will explain about issue that explain the development of IBF in the country. There are 6 issues that I summarize about explaining the development of IBF in Indonesia. The development of the Islamic banking business has not yet grown rapidly in Indonesia. It is because there are still many Islamic banks do not conduct business according to Syariah principle. Until now, not many Indonesians know about Islamic banking product and terms in Islamic banking. Only about 30% of the sources were taken to know the term Islamic banking and its level of awareness. Islamic banking is natural, Because if the cost is expensive, selling it will be expensive. This is because it is the reason why many Indonesians complain that Islamic banking is more expensive than conventional banks. Then, fourth problem is Indonesian Islamic banking products are not diverse and inaccessible to the public. Only a small number of human resources are qualified to participate while most are conventional. So, there is a human resources gap. This is due to the Indonesian society is not exposed to the interests of Islamic banks and consider conventional banks and Islamic banks are same. The last problem is lack of synergy between OJK, Otoritas Jasa Keuangan, and the government in building the Islamic finance industry. That's all from me. Thank you.